According to evidence from two studies, the current in the North Atlantic Ocean that is responsible for regulating the weather is weakening by a lot. Why does this matter? I'll fill you in here on IO. Welcome back to InformOverload, your YouTube source for doomsday prophecies. Just kidding. Kind of. But I'll get to that in a minute. I'm Charlotte Dobre. The North Atlantic Current, known as the Atlantic Meridional Overturning Circulation, or the AMOC, is responsible for transporting warm surface water northward. That heat is then released into the atmosphere. From there, colder water is carried south into the deep ocean. This ocean current acts as a conveyor belt for heat, and it redistributes heat all over the world, creating weather patterns. But if that conveyor belt suddenly stopped, we would all be in some serious trouble. I know you probably remember the film The Day After Tomorrow, where the AMOC collapses and the world is subsequently plunged into a doomsday-like scenario. The Statue of Liberty becomes covered in ice, a giant tsunami plows through Manhattan, and civilians try to escape bone-freezing temperatures by gathering around any heat source they can. Yeah, that doomsday movie was one of the scarier ones, I must admit. According to a study published in the journal Nature, samples of ocean sediment were taken from off the eastern coast of the US. These samples seem to suggest that the AMOC is weakening by about 15 to 20% since the mid 1800s. This is the weakest it's been in 1500 years. And the reason for this? Climate change. Climate change is causing the Gulf Stream, a current from the Gulf of Mexico, to warm, and there are cooler waters near Greenland. This suggests that warmer water is not being transported as effectively as it once was. Global climate change is being blamed in two ways. Warmer water lessens the amount of cooling. The warm water then can't sink. As ice and glaciers melt, the fresh water is pouring on top of the area where the water normally turns over. Less salt from the fresh water means the water will stay on the surface. To top it all off, more rain and snow in the northern areas, combined with more evaporation in the south, is changing the flow. That's according to the study's co-author, Stefan Ramsdorf. So what does this mean? While a scenario like we saw in The Day After Tomorrow is unlikely, we should be really concerned. The slowdown could mean a complete circulation shutdown, which will mess up weather patterns all over the globe. At this time, more research needs to be done. These findings were backed up by a second study also published in the journal Nature. Alrighty guys, I'm gonna respond to a couple of comments now. Dylan Portillo said, "Where's Charlotte?" Guys, I've noticed that there's a lot of comments about everyone picking favorites and saying things like, "Oh, Rebecca's better, no, Charlotte's better, blah, blah, blah." I will be your host unless I am unavailable. It is not a popularity contest, we're just trying to deliver you guys the news. If you would like to see Rebecca more often, obviously, because she's amazing, she hosts Most Amazing Top 10. Zach Moss said, "When IO and LBQ upload at the same time, you need to decide which one to watch first." I love this. Which one did you end up choosing? Obviously subscribe to Life's Biggest Questions if you haven't already. That is all folks, thank you for watching. If you need a place to get your news on YouTube, look no further and subscribe to IO. Wanna go on an IO binge? Well, there's a playlist right over there that you should check out. And IO is on social media, why don't you look at the description of this video for all our links. That's it for me, and I'll see you next time.